7-segment displays are great. We don't see them as much in electronics these days because screens are a lot cheaper than they used to be, but these used to be everywhere, from clocks to supermarket checkouts to calculators to slot machines. Here, they're being used as part of the mega processor at the Centre for Computing History in Cambridge. This is the clock speed that the whole system is running at. 7-segment displays are a really clever bit of design. 7 is the minimum number of segments required to show every number using straight lines. It doesn't matter that the 4 isn't actually how most people write a number 4. It's close enough that we've all just got used to it. And 7 segments plus a decimal point means that there are 8 lights here to turn on or off, which is convenient. Computers like working with 8s. There are 8 bits in a byte, so you can store the state of those lights in just 1 byte of memory. And you can use these for some letters too. You could show the word error or even base 16 numbers, but there's no way you can write an M or a W on this display, so here is a code question for you. What is the longest English word that you can write on a 7-segment display? I love questions like this because there are so many ways to approach them. I'm going to give one solution here because that's the way I want to tell the story, but I can think of a couple of others just off the top of my head, and there will be a dozen more that I haven't thought of or maybe couldn't even think of. To start off, we need a dictionary. Unfortunately, here the work has been done for us. There is a public domain list of English words available. I'll put the link in the description. Now, this is not a perfect list. Right at the top, there are 2 different spellings of ah, and I'm really not sure either of those should count, but the list is good enough for our purposes. We can manually filter it later if there are any strange results. Now, I'm going to code this in JavaScript using Node. Not the best language, but it's not bad for beginners, and importantly, it's easy for me to explain. First, we're going to add a bit of boilerplate code, just stock stuff to get it working. Did I know all that code off by heart? No, of course not. I googled load array from file in Node, and I adapted some of the results. This is basically how everyone codes stuff like that. Don't ever be afraid that you're not a real programmer because you still look stuff up. The important part about programming is not remembering exact words or syntax. It is breaking down a problem, working out how to solve it, and then fixing all the inevitable bugs in your solution. It's about holding lots of complicated connections in your head, not the exact magic words that you need this one time. I still forget which order to put basic stuff in sometimes. Anyway, the first line loads in the bits of Node that deal with reading and writing files, and the next line loads the entire dictionary into a single long string called words. The next line converts that single string into an array, a long list of smaller strings based on where the new line characters are. And now we have an array of all the words in the English language, basically just a long list of strings. Let's see how long that array is by telling the console to output the array's length. Okay, more than 370,000 words, each one a separate item in that array called words. Next problem, we need to filter that list and remove any words that use letters that we can't display with 7 segments, which gives us an interesting design problem. Which letters can't we display? Now, I'm going to use fancy graphics here rather than actual 7-segment displays, but for extra credit, you can try and figure out the After Effects expressions that I use to make these. Letters A through F are easy. There's almost a standard for those, but G is difficult. We can't use the obvious pattern because that's a 6 or a 9 if it's lowercase, and if we use an alternate pattern for it, it's not really a G, it's a C with aspirations. But to be fair, if any of those patterns appear at the start of a word like goal, no one's going to look at it and go, oh, 6-0. But I'm going to make the call that we don't allow it. I think I is all right, though. Like, that's clearly an I. It's not like the half-assed G, which sort of looked kind of like a C. It's clear. I mean, I don't care that I'm not applying strict rules here. I'm just going on what feels right, and if you disagree, you can fix it in your version. Other letters that I'm ruling out. K just can't be done, requires a diagonal. M, I've seen it displayed like this before, but no, not having it. N is borderline, but I'm going to allow it because there's nothing else it could be. Q is out, that is just a 9. R, I will allow if it's lowercase. S is okay, same reasons as I. But there's no way to do V or W or X, and as for Z, no, it needs the diagonals. Not having it. Here's our alphabet, then. 18 letters left, 8 disallowed. It's actually more than I'd expected left in there. And I'm going to cheat. I know this is called the basics, but doing this the long way would be really dull, so I'm going to put those disallowed letters into something called a regular expression, or a regex, or regex, whichever. Those slashes indicate that it's a regex, and whatever's inside those slashes is like a test that a string can match against. So this regex would match any word with an X in it, whether that X is start or middle or end. As long as there's an X somewhere in the string, it passes that test. If we put all our disallowed letters in, then surround them with square brackets so they're treated as a class, this regex will match any string, any word, with any of those letters anywhere in it. If a string matches this, we cannot use it. Regular expressions are a heck of a lot more complicated than this, and they can boggle even experienced programmers' minds, but using one here will save me about 5 minutes of really dull script later on. The good news is we can now just use the function match to test a string against this regular expression, which I'm calling bad letters, and it'll tell us whether there are any bad letters in there. So, how do we filter the array? One of the important trade-offs here is between code that is fast and code that everyone can understand. This is not going to be an efficient and fast approach, but because we're running it on a modern PC at the command line, and we don't mind waiting a fraction of a second after telling it to go, it's no big deal. It's more important that I can show the code and explain it and look at it again later and understand it. But imagine if something like this had to be run on the scale of YouTube or Google, running millions or billions of times a day. Every minor improvement you could make would be worth it. At some point I should do a video about big O notation, but now is not the time. Here, where we're just writing code to find the answer to one simple question, don't worry about it. Sure, there are more elegant solutions, but this is going to be easy to explain. I'm going to declare an empty string, longest acceptable word, and then I'm going to tell the code to start testing every word in the array. This line will run the code in between those brackets once for each word, and on each run through, this variable, test word, will be the next word in the list. First question, is the word we're looking at shorter or the same length as the current longest acceptable word? If it is, then we can just ignore it. We know it's not longer, it's of no use to us, and we can just say continue. That continue skips the rest of the loop, kicks us back to the start with the next word. Some people hate continue, they think it shouldn't be used anywhere because it can cause confusion, and yeah, it can. But I reckon for things like this, it's fine. Anyway, this'll save a lot of processing time because after the first few words, we're not even going to bother to analyze the short ones, we'll just ignore them. So, let's say we've got to this point in the code. It's a new, longer possible word. Is it acceptable? Here we can use our regular expression from earlier. Does the word match our test for bad letters? If it does, it's not acceptable. Ignore it. Ignore the rest of the loop. Continue on to the next word in the list. But if it's passed both of those tests, if we've got to this point, then we know our word is longer than anything we've accepted before, and it has no bad letters in it. So we change the longest acceptable word to be our new word, and we start over again with the next one in the array. And when we're done, longest acceptable word will be the longest acceptable word. We tell the code to write that out, and the result is... that's actually the longest word in the list. Anyway, you know what? I'm going to rule out I and O. They are just numbers with aspirations. Fortunately, we have made the code easy to edit, so we can just make that change, and... sure, fine, that'll do. The lesson here, I guess, is that sometimes you might write code to find something out, and the answer is really unsatisfying. Of course, there is one thing we're missing here. Our test was only checking for words longer than the current acceptable one. What happens if there was another acceptable word of the same length? We'd have ignored it. There could be multiple correct answers, but I'll leave checking that up to you. Thank you very much to the Centre for Computing History in Cambridge for lending me their space and their mega processor. Thank you also to all my proofreading team who made sure I got the script right.